Hello, Internet! Did you ever wonder about hurricanes? It doesn't really matter if we're dealing with a cyclone in the Southern Hemisphere and Indian Ocean, a typhoon in the Pacific, or a hurricane in the Atlantic. It is always an immense and powerful tropical storm. And they all start miles away over the oceans with a small disturbance in the atmosphere, with a so-called easterly wave, or they just develop on their own when the right circumstances and the thunderstorm come together. These seeds of hurricanes draw their energy from warm oceans. The sea should be at least 79 degrees Fahrenheit and for major storms 83. So they need to form below the 20th latitude in a low pressure area. At least for now, considering our ongoing global experiment of warming the planet. Since the Coriolis effect is too weak near the equator, they also need to form above the 8th latitude. This just leaves a narrow corridor for hurricanes to form. But this narrow corridor is all that's needed to create these massive monsters. We can check this data if we overlay this map with the water temperature and the origins and paths of past storms. Seems like we got it just right. Let's now say our sea cloud is located in the right spot over a warm ocean. The air, filled with water vapor from the ocean, is heating up and starts rising. This keeps on drawing the surrounding cooler air in until it's also warm enough to rise. In high altitudes, the condensing water vapor releases enough energy to warm the atmosphere, which in turn increases the speed of new air rising. This fills the thunderclouds with more and more energy, strengthening the whole process. While air keeps getting drawn in, the Coriolis effect starts off the rotation. For two really awesome videos about the Coriolis effect, please take a look in the info cards. I link both videos from Revitasium and Smarter Every Day over there. But let's go on. If we now combine the self-strengthening thunderstorm with the rotation of the Coriolis effect, we get our first small tropical depression, ever growing and speeding up along the way over the ocean. I use the Saffir-Simpson scale to classify our storm. I would be glad to tell you that this is the only one, but just like there are multiple names for storms, there are multiple scales to classify them, and every one of them is different. So let's simplify it by concentrating on the Saffir-Simpson hurricane wind scale. When our tropical depression reaches a wind speed of 39 miles per hour, it is now classified as a tropical storm, and when it finally hits a speed of 74 miles per hour, we've got our first small category 1 hurricane. With this, our storm starts developing the typical eye surrounded by the eye wall. This wall consists of a ring of thunderstorms, heavy rain, and the strongest winds. It is the most destructive part of the whole storm, especially on the side where the wind is blowing in the same direction as the whole hurricane is traveling. As if the wind force wasn't destructive enough, the hurricane also raises the local sea level, the so-called storm surge. The longer the storm keeps on getting fueled by the warm sea, the bigger and faster it gets. At a speed of 96 miles per hour, we reach category 2, category 3 at 111 miles per hour, category 4 at 130, and finally everything above 156 miles per hour is a category 5 hurricane, with a sea level increase of more than 18 feet. And we are talking here about a storm that will keep the affected area uninhabitable for weeks, if not months. Our only luck is that the storm can fuel itself over land and will rapidly lose energy until the eye wall collapses and with it the whole hurricane. But this lost energy is seen in the destruction of the coastal areas. And even without the high-speed winds, the rainstorms can carry on for a long time until they finally dissolve. Hopefully, we will learn more about hurricanes in the future to better predict them. I mean, there is sadly no way of eliminating them before landfall, not even by blowing up bombs in the eyeball while sharks are attacking the helicopter, or something like that. Well, I hope you liked this video. If you did, you know how you can help me out with this channel. And of course, you can ask any question you ever wondered about in the comments down below. And with that being said, thanks for watching. Have a good one.